ex-presenter claims that you have to win your customer's heart before everything else. And if you look back at our rhetoric history, you do realize that despite our best arguing efforts, human nature is a bit different than sometimes we realize. If we want to look at the human brain, basically where we see behavior control, it's still in our limbic brain, it still goes through our heart. But the thing is that technology is so into our private life that our emotions are attached to it. So our next speaker doesn't only say that we have to win over the hearts, but the home screens as well of the customers. And with that, we give you Dr. Robin Kier, insurance influencer and the CEO of Digital Scouting. Please welcome.
Hey guys, thank you very much. Thank you very much for the kind words. Yeah, well, I'm Robin and I have a confession to make. I am a recovering Allianz sales agent, but I have been clean for over 6 years. Thank you for the clapping, yes, thank you. But I also worked in headquarters in smaller and larger insurance companies and did some transformation projects there. I started digital scouting as a hobby, as a side hustle, and it exploded as a blog for insurance and finance professionals. And I think with like 10,000 of followers, millions of views each month. And actually, you guys are a very important part of it. So thank you very much for actually making this possible. Digital Scouting became a consulting company, and we help insurers with a few things. But today I want to share a few stories, not only how to win the hearts, minds and home screens of your customer, but especially how to make insurance sales agents, sales managers and decision makers to rock stars. And let me start with one thing. I really want to start with what really, 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 really annoys me in selling insurance. Then I will share what agents could maybe do, and then what sales managers actually could do, and in the end, what decision makers could do. And actually, But let me start with one thing. I think the insurance process, how we sell insurance, is like fishing. So we're here in front of a large lake, we have a fishing rod, and we don't actually know which fish is going to bite or is hungry. So we need to throw in the fishing rod all the time. This is how insurance sales has worked for 150 years. But now there is a second leg, it's over here. And there are also people fishing, that they actually know where the fish is or who wants to bite. They don't even know that. They do things that make the fish come to their fishing rod. And it's really interesting, we as insurance industry are still standing here and saying, we've always been doing this way. And here are like the new kids on the block, the Googles, Facebooks, and doing things quite a little bit differently. When I started my time as an agent, we had a lot of trainings at a very rundown training facility. But after 2 weeks, we got a list. And on this list, we were supposed to call customers. And there happened two things. One customer I called, he just bought a house. Great for him, bad for us, we missed the mortgage. Then another customer just changed the legal status of his company. A lot of winning, because you could actually, submit a lot of contracts there. Problem, he just did it with another agent. This didn't matter which person we called, it always seemed as if we would call the wrong person at the wrong time. While at the same time, we had a lot of people that needed our demand, but actually we did not call because they were not on the list for the corresponding month. And I really thought, you know what, you probably think, what is Robin telling his old war stories when dinosaurs were running on the surface of the earth? Actually, a few weeks ago, a very friendly lady called me and wanted to have a meeting to talk about my insurance contracts. And I just asked, I'm on your list for this month, am I? And she was like, yeah, Robin, you caught me there. So it still is done in a lot of carriers that way. And when I'm around the world and asking people that are in the sales business, I really always ask, how do you actually call these people? And do you have still these lists? And they have. And then I would want to share what we did in the training. Who of you speaks German? All right. Who could explain the word Bedarfsweckung to the people who are not German? Oh, Alexander? So, what is Bedarfsweckung?
Create demands.
Create demands, all right. So, but a large part of our training was to create demand or awaken demand. It's like awaking the undead. The people who actually do not want to talk to you, but you want to, you should convince them. And what showed me this approach of awaken or create demand is that everybody knew in the whole system that we were talking to people who actually did not want to be called. And while at the same time, there were dozens or even hundreds of customers in the portfolio that had a moment in their life where they needed our help, but we were not there because, and they did not call us because we were not on their mind. And later I worked at the headquarters of large and smaller insurers, and I needed to think a lot of times about a certain quote from Albert Einstein. And he said, the definition of insanity is doing the same thing over and over again and expecting different results. And insurance is like that. We continue to expect that the customer calls us when he has a need, but we again behave like the blind fisher in Lake One. And how does the system work like? In September, October, C-suits come together with their employees and think about how much money, revenue we need to make next year and which line of business needs to do what. And there are regions, which region needs to make how much money and which agent needs to do what, which agent has what kind of sales goals. And even so that it's going to be centralized defined. And I ask always myself, how can a decision maker in the headquarters know what Mrs. Smith in my customer portfolio that she needs in September an accident insurance? And I actually asked a lot of people and the answer was, we don't know it, but we want you to sell her the accident insurance anyway. And I think what we can learn from this is that we should not focus on goals for the company, that we should focus on the goals of the customer. We should not awaken demand like undead, that we should actually go where the demand is because our customers have the demand of our support and our products. So let's go to the agents. What could an agent actually do? I think it's really important first step to accept reality. When direct insurers are able to sell insurances cheaper than through you as an agent, they are going to dump you. The only thing that's going to save you as an agent or broker is when you have a community of loyal fans and customers who really, 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 really love you. So the big question is, how can you use technology to make customers come to you when they have the need? I think the answer is really easy. We heard one part already from Facebook. I think that one answer is social media because this is where the customers are. I would add them all, of course, GDPR compliant. I would go through the list of my last 10 years of the business cards I collected. What could you do then on social media as an agent? You know, engage with the content of your clients. You will see when they have new jobs, you will see when they bought a house, when the new baby is arriving, and you can be part of their life. And if you create content as an agent yourself, not only the automated content a lot of companies provide to you, but really true content you do by yourself, in audio, video, and text, you can really win the hearts and minds of your customers because the people like to buy from people. And a very practical step is just to block a few hours a week to listen, to start, and to create content for your customers. And the funny thing is, in Germany, there are a few agents who radically do this, and they have a funny situation. When you want to buy a full health insurance or a disability insurance, which are the most profitable insurance for the sales agent, I think, the customer needs to wait for 6 weeks to get the meeting for the video chat with this person. So they wait 6 weeks for a product they could buy at the office of another agent next door. So this really, really works, and I think these agents are really crushing it. What could the sales manager do? I think a lot of decisions ask me, Robin, my brokers and agents, they spend more time on Facebook and LinkedIn and Xing than with the client. And I say, that's great. So you need to go as an insurer or broker manager there too. Be there where your agents and brokers are. But it's really important to change, I think, the KPIs of the sales managers. Why? Instead of having the KPI, the number of visits your sales managers visit here, your broker and agents, and the number of how many times they reach them. And I think that's super important to change that. And again, also their sales manager can create micro content for their agents, for their brokers, make a podcast, a vlog, do not, you know, product education things, but, you know, share content with their agents and brokers. And the funny thing is that we did this in one project and we reduced travel costs by 30% to 50%. So all this beautiful social media magic is not only a nice to have thing and everybody's happy and it's cool, but you really can save a lot of money with it. And also you can reduce cost for staff. What to do as a C-suit? I know I'm famous for bashing them all the time, and I need to say maybe one thing very loudly. You know, insurance C-suits are neither dumb nor lazy. I mean, except the exceptions you probably all know. And a lot want to change, a lot know exactly what's going on. They really want to change things and to want to save the organizations. And some say, Robin, you know, what is your take on this? I think there are two things. You need to change the structures and the KPIs and the bonus system in your sales organization. How many times did we have the situation where we need to sell a lot of insurance in this year, but we have this list of beautiful things we really ask you to do too, but we only pay you for doing this. And at the end of the year, everybody was surprised that the sales organization really did the thing they were paid for, and you know, not so much from this side. So if you really want to say people should really use social media to enact differently with their brokers and agents and customers, we need to incentivize this. So you need to measure them not only by the amount of insurance they sell, but also by the amount of actions they undertake. For example, you know, how many micro content did they create? What kind of ratings did that get from their agents and brokers? And the funny thing is what happens, it gives the people the opportunity to have first time their fate in their own hands. Because if you have a portfolio of agents and brokers as a sales managers who are rock stars, really crushing it, you don't need to work a lot. But if you sit on a portfolio of people, you know, who are not so, you know, busy and crushing it, you can do whatever you want. You will have hard times to reach your sales goals. And what happens when you change this in actions? The person who's really, really busy and really, really likes the job, and the other one who's really a little bit relaxing on the success of the structures has some problem. And the funny thing is, we know an insurer who has done this. And you know what happened? Sales did not stop. The people even sold and continued to sell insurances. And then they say, decision makers ask me, Robin, how can I motivate the people in the organization to really, really push for this? And I say it's really, really easy. You need to talk to every single of your employees daily. And he says, Robin, I have 5,000 people or 1,000 people. I cannot talk to them daily. I say, yes, you can. Why? You can create a lot of content also internal for your own organization. May it be audio so that the people, when they sit in their car, can listen to you. May it be video messages. You can recommend the content that inspires you or that your team really finds, and really recommend TED Talks, white papers and research and all of that. And the funny thing is, most knowledge on the world is out there and it's for free. So you don't need a multi-million dollar education program for your staff. You can actually can share your content there. So, and this will be the last thing. The strategy, I think, is as a board member, not be only the role model in leading an insurance, but also in attention hacking of your customer. So, as a summary, I think we can make agents, sales managers, and C-suits, I think the whole industry can become rock stars, actually. And we can transform the industry in an industry where the customer comes to us when he has a need and not where we need to run after him because he is on a list for a certain moment. And we can have agents and brokers looking forward to the call and the visit of the sales managers because they provide a lot of value and not only drinking coffee in the office. And I think we also can have sales organization led by titans, true rock stars of the industry. I think the only thing we need to do is move from leg one to leg two, or to leave the old and to join the attention hacking revolution. Thank you very much.